a communication link has the switches alpha I as shown in figure. So all the switches can be closed or open independently. The probability of closing a switch is equal to P. Let AI is an event closing a switch. Closing alpha I. That is A1 is closing alpha 1. A2 is closing alpha 2. Find at least one event on AI so that there exists a closed path between 1 and 2. What are these 1 and 2 here? 1 and 2 are the nodes. So between 1 and 2, there must be a closed path. For that purpose, you have to find the corresponding event. That event may be A1 union A2, or it may be A1 intersection A4, whatever it may be. You have to find. Next one is find the probability of the event so that there exists a closed path between 1 and 2. See, when the closed path exists between 1 and 2, as a A1 intersection A2 intersection A5, that is, if alpha 1, alpha 2 and alpha 5 are closed, so all those three, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 5 are closed, we have a closed path. Otherwise, alpha 1, alpha 3, alpha 4, alpha 1. So therefore we have two different events. What is the first event? A1 intersection, A2 intersection, A5. Or A1 intersection, A3 intersection, A4, A5. Are they mutually exclusive? See, the closing of the upper path excludes the closing of the lower path? No. Both the paths may be closed. They are not mutually exclusive. Why? Because the switches are independent. When you switch on alpha 1, only that switch will be on. Okay. When you close it, it will be closed. When you open it, it will be open. It will not depend on the closing and opening of the other switch. Similarly, other switches will also not depend on the remaining switch. All the switches are independent. Already given it. Okay. The closing and opening of these switches is independent of each other. First, write down the events. We have A1 intersection A2. Intersection A5. So when this event occurs, so let it be E1. Let it be the event E1. When the event 1 occurs, there exists a closed path. Otherwise, so this is one possibility. And another possibility is the second event on A2, A3. So let us assume this is, that is, when the event E1 or E2 occur, then there exists a closed path between 1 and 2. Now find the probabilities.